Hello everyone, in this video we are going to solve the problem number 4 from the chapter of stress in the book of Mechanics of Materials by R.C. Hibbler. In this problem it is required to determine the resultant internal loadings acting on the cross section at point C. As you know that for determination of the internal loadings we have to cut the member at the required point and take either of the portion. So in this problem if I take the right portion of the shaft, then I must be familiar with all the forces acting at the right portion. But when you look at the figure, at point B there is a general bearing, and due to general bearing there would be a reaction at point B. So before proceeding to the required quantities, I must have the value of the reaction created due to the general bearing. The value of RB can be determined by applying the conditions of equilibrium. So before applying the conditions of equilibrium, let's draw the free body diagram of the shaft. Now the value of reaction at point B due to general bearing can be calculated by applying the third condition of equilibrium at point A, means summation of all moments acting at point A equal to zero, and I take the clockwise moments as positive. So let's calculate the moments at point A. The moment created due to the UDL would be 1200 multiplied by the moment arm. Moment arm would be 2. The moment created due to the 1200 force would be clockwise, hence positive. Now the moment created due to the RB force, which would be anticlockwise. Anticlockwise would be taken as negative, and the value of RB is unknown. And the moment arm, which would be the distance between point A to B, would be 4.5, and in the last the moment created due to 900 newton would be clockwise, hence positive. The moment arm, means the distance between A to D point, would be 6 meter. So from here we will have the value of RB, and the value of RB when you do the calculation will be 1733.33 newton. Now moving back to the actual question of the problem, that is we have to determine the internal loadings at point C, and I have taken the right portion of the shaft. So let's draw the free body diagram of the right portion. In this free body diagram we can see there are three unknowns, which are the internal loadings acting at point C and are required. So these three unknowns can be determined by using all three conditions of equilibrium. So let's apply them. The first condition of equilibrium, summation of all forces acting in x direction equal to zero. So if I take these direction as x and y, then the forces in x direction will be only one, that is nc, and if I take the rightwards as positive, then nc will be positive and there is no any other force, so then nc would be equal to zero. It means the force which is normal to the cross section at point C is zero. Now applying the second condition of equilibrium, summation of all forces acting in y direction equal to zero, and if I take all the forces acting upward as positive, then the vc is upward, so positive. 600 newton force is downwards, means negative. 1733.33 is acting upward, means positive, and the 900 newton force is downwards, means negative. So from this equation we will have the value of VC, and when we will do the calculation we will have the value of VC as minus 233 newton, and this negative sign shows that the considered direction would be altered. Now applying the third condition of equilibrium, summation of all moments acting at any point equal to zero, so if I take that point as C point, then applying the third condition of equilibrium, summation of all moments acting at point C equal to zero, and if I take the clockwise moments as positive, then the moment created due to each of force would be, the moment created due to 600 newton force would be clockwise, and its magnitude would be 600 multiplied by the moment arm, and that will be 0.5. The moment created due to 1733.33 newton force would be anticlockwise, negative, and its moment arm would be 2.5. The moment created due to the 900 newton force would be clockwise, and its moment arm would be 4, and I considered the MC as clockwise, means positive. So from this equation we will have the value of MC, and when we do the calculation, the value of MC would be 433 Newton meter. Now we have got all the three resultant internal loading acting at point C. I hope to see you in the next video. Up till then, bye bye.